Hi guys, so I've just made this REVIUNG53 keyboard into a wireless version. The modification itself is pretty straightforward. You just need to find a drop-in replacement for the ProMicro, preferably a Bluetooth controller that is compatible with the ZMK firmware. ZMK is a well-known keyboard firmware that has support for many wireless microcontrollers. So we're going to take a look at some of the controllers that are supported by the ZMK. As you can see here, there are a couple of ProMicro replacements. Some of them already have Bluetooth capability and also DIY, except for the nicenano. So there are the Blue Micro, Mikoto, nicenano itself, bunch of NRF Micro, and the last one is the Pucci BLE. Apparently, I have a spare nicenano, so I'm going to replace the ProMicro with the nicenano version 2. I get the battery first installed with the correct size so it can be slid between the headers. And I'm not gonna use any on-off buttons, so I had to rely on the slip features of the firmware. And then I soldered the cable directly to the bottom pin of the headers. Beware of the gap that you're going to make between the nicenano and the headers. I managed to have a small gap, just enough to make space for the battery. If the gap is too high, there's a chance that you're not able to put back the top plate, or else you need to print another secondary top plate to adjust with the height. As you can see, the USB connector is almost close to the top. As a result, if you are using a regular cable, it might get hindered by the top plate since the USB head is quite thick. So you need to use a slimmer USB cable like this one. There are some preparations before we continue. So we need the PCB and the schematic files for the REVIUNG53. We can check that out on the REVIUNG GitHub repository. You may download these files, the REVIUNG53.sch and the REVIUNG53.kcat_PCB. Later we're going to use these files for reference. And then you need to fork this ZMK repository, clone it to your local, and then create a feature branch for the new shield that you're going to add. There are many ways to deal with the ZMK dependencies. The easiest way, in my preference, is to use a Docker container, so you need to have Docker installed on your system, and then follow all the instructions from this page. So let's open our cloned ZMK repo. This might take a long, so I'm going to fast forward the process. So in the shields folder, there are REVIUNG41 and REVIUNG5 shields. And apparently, the REVIUNG41 already has the LED overlay configs. So I just assuming that the REVIUNG53 uses the same configs. We also need the matrix transform for the REVIUNG53. So I think I'm going to duplicate the REVIUNG41 shield and adjust all the naming. So this is the overlay file where we define a mapping from the schematic to the physical layout. But first, we're going to start mapping for the ProMicro pinouts. As you can see on the schematic, there are pins used for the columns and the rows. These pins need to be translated to the ZMK pin level. So later we need to check the documentation regarding the shield overlay. So following the guide here, ZMK used the Arduino labeled pins. So the pin labeled 21 to 10 is apparently going to be used as the columns, and the pin labeled 3 to 9 is going to be used as the rows. So let's get back to the code and apply the pin mapping. To get the coordinate from the schematic, you need to check on the diode symbol. Usually a single diode represents a single key, but could also represent two key positions depending on the user's preference. For example, on the first column, switch 15 and 16, a user can choose between two types of caps lock key. If we take a look at the PCB, it has the same switch labeling from the schematic. For example, we're going to get the coordinates for the first row and the third row of the layout. So the red one going to represent the first row and the blue one represents the third row. If we map the coordinates to the physical layout, and then we're going to have something like this. So this is how the matrix looks like after it's complete. And don't forget to edit the key map file following the new layout. And then we're going to continue compiling the firmware. You may copy the compile command from the documentations, and then make sure to execute the build command from the app directory. Use the nicenano v2 as the MCU identifiers and REVIUNG53 as the shield ID following the shield folder naming. And then execute the compile command. So the firmware file should be created on the Zephyr folder, and this is the only file that needs to be installed on the nicenano. So by the time I made this video, I had already submitted a pull request for the REVIUNG53 shield, but not yet merged. So if you want to try it on your own REVIUNG53 without having to deal with all the development stuff, there is a feature called beta testing. Basically, you just need to create new repository that contains a build configurations pointing to the pull request branch that you want to test. By default, the build config should look like this. But if you want to try features from the pull request list, you may add the pull request remote repository and then adjust all the other values. For example, I have made my own testing repository. You can also easily fork this repo if you want. So I also includes the LED and the sleep feature configurations. So since the REVIUNG53 shield is still on the pull request, we still need to point the remote branch to my fork ZMK repo and adjust everything. Next, I'm going to show you how it works. Let's say we're going to add the escape key on the keymap file, and then we're going to commit the change directly through the GitHub dashboard. So after the commit is submitted, it will trigger the GitHub actions. So it will build and compile the firmware based on your config files. It may take some time, and after it's complete, you can download the firmware file and flash it to the nicenano. Flashing is quite simple. Get the nicenano into the bootloader mode, and it should be detected as a USB drive. And then you could just drag and drop the UF2 file to the drive. Well, I guess this is everything. Drop me a comment if you want to ask something, and thank you for watching.